will be brief, but I do want to point out, as somebody who has been both for and against the port and fought many different battles, I wish that we had an administration that is good as the administration is now. I wish we had them 10 years ago. Every single thing that has been asked of them, they have done. When they ask them to address noise ordinances, they do it. When they ask them to look at pollution, they do it. When they ask about parking, they do it. Everything that has been put forward, they have done. My friends, what this is a moving target. You never will be able to satisfy this group that is out there right now. You never will. What is happening, really, this is going to end up being a bit of a pyrrhic victory for them. They are going forward, they're saying they're going to go to court, and they're going to try and fight it out in court. Well, when the court turns around and unilaterally dismisses them, we will have a victory here in the city of Charleston, I promise you that. Yeah. If you want to sue somebody, sue the state of South Carolina. Sue the city of Charleston. Sue the SBA. But to try and sue a client, to create a climate of ill will, is sickening. That is a direct affront to every business here in Charleston, South Carolina. And again, I'm proud to stand here with the Ports Authority. I'm proud to stand here with the mayor and all these fine citizens. And I look forward to the day when you say we beat this.
Leon Stavrinakis, State House of Representatives. Representative Merrill did a great job right there, hitting a lot of very important points. I'd like to point out a couple of things so that people don't forget. Number one is that Carnival Cruise Lines made this commitment to Charleston, South Carolina, in the middle of the worst economic downturn in any of our lifetimes. I mean, when everybody else was pulling back and saving money, Carnival came here and made an investment in Charleston and showed trust in us. And I want to thank you, Mayor Riley, and the court for coming out so strongly, and other business leaders coming out so strongly against this lawsuit. I think Representative Merrill, like I said, hit it really, really squarely on the head. This is dangerous. When you're coming after the industries that we rely on to provide jobs and economic security for the families that live in Charleston, South Carolina, that is a dangerous precedent, and we need to strike back. And I thank them again for doing this today and for hitting back so forcefully. In the General Assembly, I have a 90% conservation lifetime voting record, pro-conservation 90%. So in Representative Merrill's, is as good or better. So we have a commitment long-term for preserving the environment, and the beautiful environmental heritage of Charleston, South Carolina. We are not standing up here as people who have been longtime enemies of environmental preservation in Charleston. We are quite the opposite. And instead of suing Carnival Cruise Lines, we want to thank them for going above and beyond the call of duty and their legal obligations to help us preserve the beautiful environmental heritage of Charleston, South Carolina.